Sridhar, you want to take that? You had, I mean, how did you resist the temptation to not raise money when people would have been lining up checks for a B2B company, especially focused on the US? I mean, how did you resist the temptation?
Yeah, actually, it's not as difficult as it sounds. One of the leading venture capitalists, I won't name, they called me for a session, a lunch meeting they organized for their portfolio companies. They invited me over because they said, we can see how much value we add for our portfolio companies, and you can talk to all our entrepreneurs, some of them. So I went there. I thought, okay, I'll check them out. And I went there, and we had lunch, and I was talking to many of the people, and they were out of earshot of the VCs. They were asking me, why are you here? You haven't raised money. They said, well, they invited me to see if, you know, see for myself how the how much value they can add. They said, don't take the money. Two or three people came and said, don't take the money. That's excellent marketing. Okay, I thought. They said, don't take the money. So I thought, okay, that settles it. That was a true story. But seriously, the reason I didn't take the money is I felt we have the freedom. Look, I don't know that if I'm running a big VC company, I can sit in Tenkasi in a village like this and do what I do. It kind of will, they will have issues with it.
Right. Nitin, no? You want to take that? Did you also have similar conversations with VCs who perhaps wanted to fund you and you decided not to go ahead?
No, I mean, I absolutely think freedom.
And it would have actually been even more difficult for you because, you know, at least Sridhar, I think, started up in the 90s. He kind of built it over the last, you know, 2-3 decades. And we did not have this kind of interest in the internet ecosystem. It's something that started perhaps post 2010, 2012, you know, post the Flipkart phase. And that is actually a time when people would have been lining up to give you checks and you, you know, decided to resist the temptation. So do you also have a backstory like Sridhar on what exactly happened and why you decided to build the way you have built Zerodha?
The thing is, in my previous avatar, I used to manage people's money. I used to manage portfolios and I hated the obligation money brought on the table. You know, I mean, I hate to pick up a phone call when I don't want to pick up the phone call, you know, so.
That's a good one. Okay, that's a great reason. I have the same way. Actually, I'm a private person and I don't like constantly, you know, being busy. So that's actually true for me too.
And then the first few years, money would have helped us. But then as we grew the business, we got lucky that we chose an industry where we don't need to advertise to grow, right? Because in a business of investing, most advertising actually happens through word of mouth. As in, you don't get up one day, look at a newspaper and say, you know what, I want to invest in the markets, right? You get up one day, you meet a friend, your friend says, you know, I'm investing, I can help you. So you ask your friend, where do I invest? And so we knew that as long as we stay ahead in terms of our product and all our initiatives, word of mouth will eventually kick in, right? So that conviction was always there. It's become tough, you know, in the last 2-3 years, as in when the value of those checks being offered is increasing, you know, you know, it's very tough to say no to them, right? And that's where, you know, like that was a question I had for Sridhar, actually saying, you know, say in 2007, why? Because Sridhar was building for the world, right? As in, it was not India specific where VC investing got hot. I'm sure Sridhar would have got checks, you know, in 2007 as well, right? Before the entire bust happened.
Definitely from about 2000, we have been constantly quoted by VCs every year.
So. Right. So, but then say in 2009-10, when the world kind of, you know, when the shit hit the fan types, right? Did you at that time regret not raising money? If there was a bad phase, you know, was there ever a situation where you said, you know what, I should have raised money in 2007 when it was hot?
No, actually, in fact, I'll give the analogy today. I mean, it's probably the greatest time to raise money is today, right? Or the last six months. I mean, they're insane valuations. But we are not raising money, and I have no regrets about not raising money because it always comes with strings attached. Okay, it always does. And you know, if you raise money today, maybe it'll be fun for a couple of years. In the sixth or seventh or eighth year, and I'll give you one metric. And I've been doing this for 25th year now. A lot of people who started like this are burnt out, and they are not in this anymore. They're not actually doing this. And the reason is that there is a, you know, that, that that's a serious issue that people cannot keep doing this this grow at all costs thing forever. I mean, it's like steroid for the body. Right. You know, athletes who take steroids can do well for some period, but then the body breaks down, right? It's the same thing with companies, I believe. So if we try to grow too fast and take this, you know, huge steroid infusions, the culture, something happens, and even the very senior people, the founders, get tired of it.